When you wake up to the flat earth reality, you look back to your childhood and you think about how ridiculous and how you bought into the whole ball earth idea, how trillions of gallons of water could somehow stick to the side and the bottom of the ball earth, according to science, due to gravity, which is only a theory. Now, I saw this footage today of this huge cargo ship out in the ocean, and the person filming is using a P900 digital camera. Let's take a look at this footage here. Okay, well, it zooms out. And one thing I want to mention before playing the video, just imagine so-called gravity holding down these huge containers on this cargo ship due to supposed gravity, which again is only a theory. But take a look at the bottom. You can see the bottom, of course, or the water level of the boat itself. You can see the waves striking the sides. Now, take a look here. Again, zooming out as the cargo ship completely disappears, gone, out of sight, nowhere. I understand this is a little bit elevated, but still, from this perspective, you're not looking around the so-called ball earth. 100%. This is, without a shadow of a doubt, proof. Again, we live on a flat earth. Now, let's take a look here, as I shown earlier, with the so-called ball earth. I mean, completely ridiculous. Just imagining a ship settling on the side or the bottom of the so-called ball earth. Now let's take a look at these photos of these huge cargo ships, one China shipping line. All these containers, I guess, being held down by that magical force called gravity. Take a look here, some more photos. Again, these huge cargo ships. Just imagine these going around the so-called ball earth. Completely ridiculous. Again, once you're awake, water always is level. Finds its level. Okay, take a look here as well. Now imagine this. One of these cargo ships going on, again, the side of the ball earth, and how everything remains upright. Now take a look at this photo. This one cargo ship and all these containers leading to one side, and I'm sure some fell into the ocean itself. But again, somehow on the ball earth, this doesn't happen. And you can clearly see, of course, the ship itself, you know, the water's flat. And people don't understand, can't comprehend the deception, how deep it goes. And I want to point something else out as well. People that so-called love the ball earth, it's not about loving the ball earth. They don't like the idea of being told they've been deceived their whole entire lives. 40, 50, 60 years of believing this lie of the ball earth. That's their ego talking to them. Now let's take a look at this photo. With this one huge ship docked. And you see, of course, the ropes holding it into position. Just imagine how supposedly powerful gravity is to be able to hold the ship, you know, say for example it's on the side of the ball earth, into position. Completely ridiculous. Take a look here at some more photos. These are from Antarctica, and I find it interesting with this one ship. It's a icebreaker. It's called Aurora. I touched upon Aurora recently in a video, the occult of Aurora. And again, somehow these ships on the bottom of the ball. Completely ridiculous. And the people that believe in the so-called ball earth, they always talk about how, you know, wouldn't we go over the edge if we live in a flat earth? No, we don't go over edge. You actually, if you believe in the ball earth, you're the ones going around the so-called curve or edge. Simple as this. If you follow my channel, you'll know this. Antarctica is an ice wall, ice ring that surrounds the whole world, basically keeping the oceans in. It's that simple. These ships, again, do not go around the so-called ball earth. Believe in this huge ship on the bottom. Give me a break. Now, to conclude this video, I want to show one more video footage, again, of perspective. This is what it's all about with these ships. When people believe they see these ships going around the so-called ball earth, I'm going to play this one last clip. I played it before, but just for reference. Again, as this person is ground level on the beach. Someone could talk about, oh, the footage I showed earlier was a higher elevation. Well, what excuse do you have here? This is from ground level. As the guy with the camera pans back, you're going to see that boat and that buoy disappear right here. There you go. gone out of sight. Not around the so-called ball earth. It's all due to perspective. That simple. So again, there's going to be those. They're going to rage, get all upset. And again, that's their ego talking to them. They cannot handle the fact that, again, they've been deceived their whole entire lives. And no evidence in the world is going to convince them. Because their ego is much more powerful than their brain, of course. And it takes over their mind. The ego is the, like I said so many times, the ego, the human ego, is the biggest obstacle, the biggest enemy to truth. There's your obvious footage once again. Ship is completely gone, disappeared. Don't live on a so-called spinning ball, traveling at 66,600 miles an hour, as we're supposedly spinning at 1,100 miles an hour at the equator. Give me a break. Completely ridiculous. This video, if you cannot see by now, we do not live on a so-called ball earth. You're never going to get it. Play this last clip to conclude the video. Clear as day. Let it sink in for all you that are still in love with the whole idea of the ball earth.
The law of gravity was discovered by Sir Isaac Newton in 1687. That's almost 200 years ago, Uncle Evan.
But there is only one law. The law of God.
What is gravity?
You have no idea. Okay, next question.
Wow.
No, here's the difference. We can describe gravity. Okay. We can say what it does to other things. We can measure it, predict with it. But when you start asking, like, what it is, I don't know.
We born not knowing. Are we born knowing all? We growing wiser. Are we just growing tall? The earth was flat. If you went too far, you would fall off. Now the earth is round. If the shape changed again, everybody would have started love. The average man can't prove up most of the things that he chooses to speak of. And still run research and find out the root of the truth that you seek of. Scholars teach in universities and claim that they're smart and cunning.
The earth was flat, if you went too far, you would fall off. Now the earth is round, if the shape changed again, everybody would have started laugh. The average man can't prove up most of the things that he chooses to speak of. And still go research and find out the root of the truth that you seek of. Scholars teach in universities and claim that they're smart and cunning.